Included in those 500,000 patient admissions were almost 25,000 consecutively admitted critically ill patients. Now, our hospitals that we examined were adult hospitals. They weren't pediatric, so that's an important distinction. However, the age spectrum generally would range somewhere between age 16 years of age and the end of life, so upwards of 90 or sometimes 100 years old. So we found in the Ontario context that despite roughly equal numbers of males and females in the general patient population, and equal numbers of males and females admitted to our hospitals, males were much more frequently admitted to the intensive care unit than were females. And that seemed to hold despite similar severity of illness when people came into the hospital. It also seemed to hold for medical and surgical diagnoses, nearly irrespective of the kind of the reason for admission to hospital. And while in hospital and in the intensive care unit, we found that men were much more likely to receive certain aggressive life-supporting treatments while in the intensive care unit, such as mechanical ventilation or aggressive blood pressure monitoring and catheterization of blood vessels. Well, I think that, you know, what we have found so far is that men and women do appear to be treated differently when they become critically ill. Now, the reasons for that are still unclear. As we talked about, it could be that there is a biologic explanation for our findings. There may be differential decision making on behalf of patients or the decision makers or the healthcare team, and we really do have to try to figure out why that might be. We are doing some more work to investigate the potential for differential decision making and are performing some pretty detailed interviews of patients that have the potential or have become critically ill in the recent past, their decision makers and the healthcare team, to decide whether people do have different preferences, to decide whether people would think about critical illness and the kinds of therapies that they may want to administer to loved ones, based upon gender and based upon age, and whether or not physicians and nurses and the healthcare team might have different preconceived notions about the kinds of therapies that are appropriate across the lifespan for men and women.